Hi and hello, I am Athena Pontian here. Welcome to the Anatomy for the Biomedical Engineers classroom once again. Today we are going to see the next topic of the muscular system. That is, yesterday in the previous video we just saw the introduction about the muscular system. Today we are going to discuss about the types of the muscles of the system. That is, each and every type separately and what is the function of each and every type. All the things we are going to discuss today. Come, let me start the class now. We know that under the muscular system there are three different types of muscles are there. One is skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle and smooth muscle. So these are all the three main important muscles that is present or coming under the muscular system. See, the first type of the muscular system is skeletal muscle. The name itself shows that skeleton plus muscles. So the muscles that is coming under the muscular system is binded over the skeletal body. That is called as the skeletal muscle. Of course, we know that. Then, this particular skeletal muscle is fully made up of, or it is in the form of the striated muscle tissue. Striated muscle tissue. And it is made up of sacromius. Please remember. Striated muscle tissue is nothing but just like an arrangement as line by line. So this is the arrangement of the striated muscle tissue and it is fully made up of the sacromius, please remember. And along with this particular striated arrangement, this particular skeletal muscle is made up of the connecting tissue. It is made up of the connecting tissue. This particular connecting tissue is particularly for giving information or receiving information from the nerve fibers. Okay, this connecting tissue made a bridge between the nervous systems of the human body. Then this particular skeletal muscle is binded over the bone through the collagen fibers are called the tendons. That we already know that in the definition itself, tendon is the definition. It's nothing but it's a connection made between the bone and the muscles. So the bunch of collagen fibers that is emerging out from the muscles and connected to the bone, that is called as the tendon. Of course, we know that these particular muscles is fully made up of the connecting tissue. These connecting tissues are togetherly called as the fascia. Okay, this fascia is covered by the three different layers. One is epimysium, perimysium and endomysium. Okay, inside that the muscle fibers are there. Please remember, the whole skeletal system is fully made up of, it is made up of the connecting tissue. That particular connecting tissue is particularly for receiving and giving the information to the nervous system. That connecting tissue is togetherly called as the fascia. That fascia consists of three different layers. Inside that, the muscle fibers are present. The three layers are called the epimysium, perimysium and endomysium. Okay, that is the three layer that is protecting the muscle fibers especially. That is particularly for receiving and giving the information of nervous system. According to the action made by the skeletal muscle, we can able to classify the muscle in the way of these different types, that is five different types. In that is flexor, extensor, adductor, abductor, levator, depressor, supinator, pronator, that is sphincter, tensor and rotator. So these are all the muscle that is coming under the classification of the skeletal muscle. This is particularly classified on the basis of their action. Come, let me see the each and every types function, okay, according to the action. Come, let me see what is flexor and what is extensor. These two are coming under especially in the joint action. This flexor, it decreases the anterior angle at the joint. This extensor increases the anterior angle at the joint. What mean is, for example, just take an example of this elbow. If I want this flexor action, when it appears is, if you want to decrease the anterior angle like this, this flexor muscle is activated. Extensor is nothing but, this extensor helps this particular anterior angle will increase. We just stretch the elbow like this. So anterior ankle increased and decreased action is done by this flexor and extensor. The next is the abductor and adductor. This is particularly the movement of bone away from the midline and closest to the midline. The muscles that is move away from the midline of the human body, that is called as the abductor. The abductor muscle especially do the function, it is move away from the midline of the human body. Okay, then this particular abductor is nothing but the movement of the muscle that is closest towards the midline. The next type is levator and depressor. The levator and depressor is especially for increasing and decreasing the structure of the muscles. While we are increasing the structure of the muscle is done by the levator muscle. The decreasing of the structure can be done by the depressor muscle. Okay. In some position we need to stretch the muscle. For example, if you want to stretch the muscle like this, this particular levator muscle gives the structure to increase. In some other cases, if you want to bend your knee or if you want to bend your body and go inside some of the small holes like this, we need to decrease the structure of the muscles. That is done by the depressor. Okay, so increasing the structure is done by the levator, decreasing is done by the depressor. The next type is supinator and pronator. The supinator action is nothing but if you want to move the palm up, the supinator. This particular pronator is nothing but if you want to move palm down, then that is called as the pronator action. Okay, so this is the supinator action, pronator action, especially in the palm region. If you want to move the palm up, the supinator. If you want to move the palm down, that muscle is called as the pronator. Then the last is sphincter, tensor and rotator. We know that this sphincter muscle is present especially in the opening of the human body. Okay, so this sphincter muscle gives us the decrease action and increase action of the opening. This tensor muscle gives the tensest nature of the human body. This rotator gives the ankle rotation or axis rotation of the body. Then the next type of the muscle is cardiac muscle. So of course the name itself shows that cardiac plus muscle, the cardiac is always represent heart. So the heart is covered by the specialized muscle called the cardiac muscle. See, what is the need of the specialized muscles required for the heart? Because the function of the heart is contraction relaxation. That is fully depending on the muscles of the heart. So that is why there is a special tissue is made in the heart. That is called as the cardiac tissue, and the muscles covered by that particular region is called as the cardiac muscle. Okay, this function is especially contraction and relaxation. Give the strength to the human heart. Okay, this particular thing is also made up of the striated muscle fibers or muscle tissue. As like as the skeletal muscle, this particular cardiac muscle is also made up of the striated muscle. It's just like a line-like arrangements. Okay. This particular cardiac muscle is covered by the three layer. That is, the middle layer is most important because it is very, very thicker in layer. This is called as the myocardium. And of course, the outer layer is called as the epicardium and inner layer is called as the endocardium. So that is the thing you need to remember. This particular thicker layer gives the strength to the heart. Especially we know that the two layers, the two regions of the heart is upper auricle and lower ventricle. the lower ventricle size very thicker because it need to push the blood move up. But the layers of the auricle, the walls of the auricles are very thin compared to the ventricles. So these particular ventricles is fully made up of the thicker myocardium cell. When compared to the auricles, this myocardium is very thick in this ventricle part. So that is the thing you need to remember. The next type of the muscle is smooth muscle. The name itself shows that very smooth in nature. Okay, this is not made up of the striated muscle as like at the skeletal and cardiac. This smooth muscle is not made up of the striated muscle tissue. Okay, it is not made up of the sacromius. This is spindle in nature. That is spindle muscle is look like. The spindle is nothing but wide in the middle region and tapped in the ends. Okay, that is the structure. It is look like a hollow nature it is given. Because this smooth muscle is present exposurely in the hollow structure of a human body. Hollow structure is nothing but your arteries, your veins, your capillaries, your ureter, your esophagus, your small intestine, your large intestine. All the thing is like a pipe-like structure. It is a hollow. That is a wide in the middle and a tapped at the end. That is like a tube-like structure. All the things require the smooth nature of muscles. That is given by this. Smooth muscles. Okay, so these structure all required some of the smooth nature ability that can able to given by this smooth muscles. Okay, if you want to this particular muscle to give a peristaltic movement, then this particular smooth muscle is required. Apart from that, it called the food material or air or whatever in the blood can't able to move freely. So that is what these particular muscles are not made up of the striated muscle. This is spindle in nature. It is very smooth in structure. Okay, so this is the main thing you need to require. So that's all about the today's class. We have just discussed about the three different types of the muscular system, that is skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle and smooth muscle. We have just hold the topic today. You just please remember some of the terminologies, especially we are using these particular three types of muscular systems. You just keep on remembering and keep on understanding what are the new terminologies you can able to understand regarding this muscular system. Okay, these are all the things very helpful for you to do any research in the muscular system. Okay, thank you very much.